Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant and certified Canva creator. And in this Canva 2.0 tutorial for Instagram, we're going to be walking through how to make awesome quote posts as well as Instagram story posts using the power of Canva, both the mobile app and the one you can use on your computer or laptop. Make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some other helpful links to help you with your content marketing plan for Instagram. Now, before we dive into Canva and look at how we can post to Instagram, there's one big key to success that's going to save you a lot of time and headache and put you above the rest of the people who are just getting started with Instagram, and that is making sure you have a theme. So there's two elements to the theme. Number one is planning out how your posts are going to look. As you can see here in this example, I used to just post randomly and there was no real rhyme or reason when someone came to my feed and started scrolling through. Things were just all over the place and it looked like a mess. Now I've zeroed in and I started alternating the types of posts I did, so at least made some very basic pattern. This is certainly not something to write home about, but as you can see between these two, the second one where I alternate a white background versus a photo background, it's a lot cleaner when someone's scrolling through versus just willy-nilly everywhere. And now that I'm actually posting some videos, which we'll get to in a later Instagram tutorial, you can see that we're still trying to follow some sort of approach to make sure that there is a congruency between when we're posting things so that when someone scrolls through your feed, it doesn't look like a complete mess. The second thing is making sure that you choose 1 to 2 fonts. As we dive into my screen, I'll actually walk you through the fonts I recommend using, and you can choose 1 or 2 of them, and then you never have to worry about fonts again. One of the quickest ways to make your feed look ugly is by choosing a bunch of different style of fonts, which is a big mistake I made. So let's go ahead, jump in. Here at the home screen on Canva, we go ahead and click on Create a Design. Now, if we were doing a Instagram post, we go ahead and click on Instagram 1080 by 1080 is the dimensions. And then if we're doing a story, it would be 1080 by 920. So we will actually go through both, but first we're gonna start off with the quote post. So if you don't know what fonts to use, these are the fonts I currently recommend. You can go ahead and pause the video here, or always come back, timestamp table of contents, to test out these fonts and see which ones work best for you. Now, when it comes to creating quote posts, there are only a couple of key things you need, and then after that, you can either template the process over and over again, or you can try and get more creative. So the first thing we'll do is we'll just start with a blank template here. And of course, the fastest way is just using some basic elements and a quote. So we'll come over here to text, and you can scroll through here to see the different styles of text to get some kind of inspiration. Typically, I don't actually like using these because when you click on them, they've combined all of the text together, so you have to ungroup, and then it's just kind of a mess. So I just scroll through these to get some inspiration and examples, and then I'll go ahead and click on heading. I'll choose one of our recommended fonts here. Let's just go this one, and then I'll start by typing in my post. All right, just a fun post, nothing holds you back. We'll go ahead and make this nice and big, and then we'll bold it. Nothing holds you back. There we go, cool. So if we wanted to just this to be the only thing, we could go ahead and something I like doing is highlighting or changing the color of one of the words to kind of accentuate it a little bit. So we'll go ahead and accentuate nothing and we'll make it red. And then what we can do here is we can go over to elements and we can add a quick background here. So something I've done in the past, go ahead and, whoops, wrong element there. We'll go ahead and choose just a normal square and we can turn it on its side and pull it through here. And then what we can do is we'll change it to, let's just do a light blue or something. And then we'll go ahead and click on position, move it backward. And well, nothing to write home about, but again, just showing you how quickly you can put these together. And you can come up here and play with the transparency as well. So if you just want a kind of a blue tint, there you go. And, or you could just leave it blank. The other thing I of course recommend is having your logo. This is something that I created outside of Canva. So I'll go ahead and just choose my signature here and I'll make it nice and small. Of course it's white, so it's showing up terribly. And I probably should have chosen the blue one. Let's jump cut to that. And there's our basic text quote post. Okay, yeah, we probably want to do a heck of a lot more than this. So let's get more complicated. I'll go ahead and duplicate this. Also scroll down here so you can see a couple of examples of what you can do. I've posted a lot of posts that look just like this one plain, or you can have fun with it. Dream big and just a pineapple there. Or I will not yield. So there are a lot of different things you can do, but let's go ahead and make a post that actually has a picture. So we'll leave this here for now. And there are two websites I recommend for finding pictures for your quote posts. The first one is Pexels and the second one is Unsplash. Both of them allow you to use all of the images that are there for free. So let's go ahead here and type in boxing. That seems like something that would be close to nothing holding you back. And scrolling down here, this one looks pretty good. So we'll go ahead and download it for free. We'll go back over to Canva, and then we'll be able to click on folders to click and upload it. So we'll upload our image here. All we have to do is click and drag it, and it will show up in the background here once we make it the full size. So typically I just click and drag until the entire length is taken up, and then I'll center it like so, and then we'll go up to position. It didn't automatically put it backward, only it does. And then obviously now we need to change the color of our text because you definitely cannot read that. So we'll go ahead and click that, and we certainly need something that's bolder and thicker. So coming back up here to my titles, let's go Lotto Heavy for this one. And jumping ahead here, all I did was put them on one line and then I just spaced until I got it spaced out like this. Now, of course, the problem is we still can't read it, right? It's very hard to read. And unless we do some really contrasting color like orange, just for example purposes, I wouldn't actually post it like this. Unless you do something like this orange, it's going to be very hard to read. So something we can do that I actually do a lot is we can go ahead and click on elements and get a box here. And there's two things you can do. This is going to be the first one. The first hack we can do is bring it over so it's covering up just the text. And then we will put it behind the text. So we'll put the position backwards. Nothing holds you back. Okay, then you definitely, now we can't see the picture, right? So, and this is where we can play with transparency. And we can bring the transparency up and down. And so we can bring the transparency up a little bit or down a little bit so that it's very easy to read the text while you can still see the background image. Now, obviously there's a lot more we could do here, and I'm going to keep saying there's a lot more. The goal of this particular tutorial video for Canva and Instagram is simply to just show you how you can play with very simple elements to get something that looks decent right out of the gate. So, you know, we're not all designers, so this is something that is very easy to do and put together. And there we go, there is our quote post, right? So something we could do with our feed design is this could be one that we plan to have on the left hand, or it's opposite for you, but we could plan to have on the left hand side. And then the next one that we do, if we were to copy over, copy it down, the next one we could do is we could put the quote on the opposite side. So that way when you're planning out your feed, you have a quote here, you have a quote here, and then maybe the center one would have the quote in the middle. So just simple things you can do to show people who show up to your Instagram account that you actually planned ahead more than just one post. So that does it for how to create a quote post. Again, those two websites are Pexels and Unsplash. They have a ton of images, more images than you would ever need. And of course, what I recommend doing is choosing your fonts and then just leaving these in here. That way it's very easy to create your posts over and over again as you post to Instagram. So these are ones that you can do ahead of time because they are quote posts, so you don't necessarily have to do them in real time or on the go like you would with a story, which is what we will talk about next. So when it comes to stories, typically what you want to do with stories is you'll either plan them out 100%, so you'll be doing a story going through the same design that we just went through, where you're going to design the whole image, or you can put something together that's going to allow you to quickly design your posts on the fly. And that's where these designs come in. So there are two different types that we'll go through. The first type is grids. So what's very nice, I'll show you how to do these in a second, is you can choose grids and have these ready to go. So as you take pictures on the fly, you can just drop them in to this pre-done template and then upload it directly to Instagram. You can also, and this is an example of what it could look like with a picture, so I'll go through this. And then of course you can also set up a graphic or image that has some elements that you consistently want to use. So this is one example. This is another example, and all you have to do is drop in the picture that you just took, and now you have a series of templates that you can just drop in your picture, and you'll be ready to go. So let's scroll up here, and we'll come over to Elements, and I'll just show you how this works. So if you want to pre-do your filter and have your filter saved for all of your images, like let's say you just want to take one type of image, or you want to take one type of filter, then all we have to do is, I'll go ahead and just use this free image as an example, is we can click on the image once we've clicked and dragged it in, and we can click Adjust, and we can adjust all the settings, and then you can have this filter code applied every time you drop in an image. Or we can come over here and click on filter, and we can click through the stock ones that they have. Let's just leave it on Nordic here. So this will be a great example. Now let's say we took a different picture on a different day. Now we want to post it. We can click and drag it over, and it will apply the same filter. So if we click on filter, you can see it's still on Nordic. So here's how to do this. Let's go ahead and duplicate this, and then we will just delete everything and start from scratch. And to do this, you're going to go ahead and click on grids. Now you can see there are a bunch of different grid options. Now what's really nice with Canva 2.0 versus 1 is any one of these grids that you click are automatically going to be sized to our story. So if we click just this first one here, that's 1, and that's all I used up here. And all you have to do is drag one image in, and then you'll be able to set up your filter. So you see here, I'm clicking on it, I can't set my filter up. Whereas this one up top, I click on it and I have all those options. So you can just drop in any image you want or an image that's similar to the type that you post quite a bit. And then you can go ahead, make your adjustments, duplicate it, and actually just click and drag the picture. I'll go through how to do it on your phone in a little bit here. So I'm just going to scroll through these so you can see there are a lot of different options in terms of what you can do with grids. I do recommend going through and finding your grids before you actually are on the fly with your phone, because it's a lot harder to go through these grids when you're on the app versus here, and it will sync, just takes a few minutes. So I'll scroll through here, and this one's just an example. I'll show you actually a live posting using this grid. And another option we have, I'll go ahead and click on this, click position and click backward so you can see, is you can add basic elements on top to kind of create a frame for your images. So for this example, this is a line that I just made big, so it kind of looks like a fire. I dropped in my logo, and then I have a black slash at the top. So now I can click and drag images in here, and every time I do, each post will automatically have these, and I can just drop in the images as I go through them. And it's the same thing with this example, and of course this example. So enough with the examples. I do actually want to show you the way I put this together is I actually used a square element. So if we go back to elements, you got to click X out of grids. So if we go back to grids, I'm getting confused here. Bear with me. We click on shapes. You'll see that there's actually an element where you can click and it has a border. You actually don't want to use this element because then you won't be able to click and drag your image because of the way things are layered. This border will be in front of everything. So what you actually want to do instead is click on just the normal rectangle and then make it as small or big as you want and then click and drag to the side. That way it's not on top of your frame that you've added. So quick tip there to save you some time and headache, because you'll click and drag and you'll go, why isn't it working? So with that, let's go ahead. We've gone through relatively quickly how to put these together. So let's jump into the app and I'll walk you through how to actually use these in real time. And of course, the first step is getting a picture. So let's go ahead and just take a picture of the laptop as if we're making the video for the video right now. I'll scroll down to the one we made. So we'll just go ahead and use that one. So we'll want to go over to Canva now, and we'll open up our story designs. So something you'll notice here is these are blank, and you'll see that there's an image here. Something that's kind of annoying is actually when you're going through these, you'll see that when you have just grids and you don't have a picture in them, you're not actually going to be able to see what the grid is. So if I click on number 2 here, And then I click on it again and I go to Images Pro and I'll just drop in some sample images. You'll see now I'm able to see where the grid is. So if we go over to this one that has several, I'll just click and now you can see where the actual grid images are, Images Pro, and we'll click that again, right? So now you're actually able to see where the what the grids look like. So I highly recommend going through and just dropping in templated or just random pictures. So when you're scrolling through this, you're able to quickly see, oh, I want to use this grid, or oh, I want to use that grid. So there's a quick example here, there. Let's go ahead and use our basic grid with these two icons here. So we'll tap to add something, and I'm clicking on the actual grid that's in the background, and we can go to our pictures, click on the most recent one, and it will drop it into the background. And just like this, I'll go ahead and say yes, now we have our story post. And that's really all there is to it. We've just dropped in our picture, and I'll just go through another example here. Let's say we want to drop it into the money picture for some reason. So we'll come up here, we'll go ahead and drop in our image, and you'll see it's automatically put into the background. Now this example doesn't look all that great, and maybe we would type like making money with Instagram or something silly like that. But that's really all you need to do when it comes to making Instagram posts. So let's go ahead and go through one more example here, number 8. We'll tap to add something to the background grid, and we can actually go straight to our camera. So I'll go straight to my camera, and let's say we want to pull in the coffee, and we'll just take a random picture of the coffee and my duct taped charger. There we go. So we've just taken the picture, and now we'll be able to easily drop it in to our template. Not the best looking picture, but I think you get the idea. So this is really where the power of Canva comes in, because it's super easy to just drop in your pictures on the fly or create these nice little grids of your images. So I'll make a grid of our images, and we'll just choose a random third one here. Okay. Perfect. There we go. So there's our grid. So very quickly, we've come up with a couple of posts. So now it's time to actually post one as a story. So let's go ahead and do this one as a story. So instead of clicking download, we'll click upload. We'll go to Instagram and it'll automatically pull up the page we're looking at, which is 11. And we'll go ahead and continue to posting it. Now here you'll have the option to do feed or stories. We are doing a story, so we'll go and click on that. And it should pull up Instagram automatically for us with it all formatted. So if we wanted to add any extra stickers or captions, we can. I'll just go ahead and click send to and share to my stories and click done. So now when we go to stories, we can see this one I just posted and one I made earlier when I was putting together this particular video. So this one was made in Canva, and then this next one is made in Canva. And that's all there is to it, to creating quote posts for your feed. And then of course also making story posts very quickly using Canva templates, and of course creating your own story templates as well. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more Canva tutorials and Instagram growth hacks, just like the ones covered in this video. Have fun creating in Canva, and until the next video, keep building the business you love.